Hello there. Sunday evening, June 6, 2021, 7:21 p.m. Hello there. Hope you had a good day, and welcome to this little broadcast. Before I forget, I just want to say that the left, liberals, Democrats, whatever you want to call them, they're basically master manipulators, okay? I was watching, finally wandered over to CNN today. Reliable sources with Brian Seltzer or whatever. And he was interviewing Jen Psaki, the White House press secretary. And everything was like, she was saying, was like just slamming the last 4 years and making it look like they are normal. Okay, that's what they're doing now, is they're making, they're manipulating everything to where they're the normal ones. But see, what they're doing is they're burying the whole lie. I don't know why they hate. Let's just forget everything that they made up about President Trump. I don't understand why, when he and his wife came down the escalator, why they automatically just hated him. It would probably be the same hate for any other Republican, but I think because possibly that he was successful, and they will say he wasn't successful or that he cheated and blah blah blah, they are master manipulators. So I just encourage you to just, you know, feel free to weigh both sides and try to take your hate out of the equation. Okay? Just try to remove the hate out of the equation and see what happens. I'm just saying, because I don't know what else to tell you. I don't want to tell you to think like me or think like somebody else. But if you just start studying the truth and searching for the truth, then you will come to the truth, okay? And so, anyway, that's all I have to say about that. Now I'm going to get into the word here. But I just was, they just went on and on and on, and she just insinuated basically that the last 4 years, just the way they frame their sentences, it's just masterfully manipulation. And I don't know how to do it. I guess I believe I'm walking in truth. Maybe they believe they're walking in truth also, but I don't understand how you can twist things so well. It's just like total liars. And there's no conscious. They don't have a conscious. It's like the Bible talks about a seared conscious. And that's a very dangerous place to be. It's a very, very dangerous place to be. So, but, you know, I can't talk anybody into my way of thinking or try to convince you. I can try to convince you to just search for the truth yourself. And that's the best way that you'll come out in the end. Hopefully you'll not see eye to eye with me necessarily, but you'll begin to see. So I've said enough about that. It just amazes me. I just can't even imagine how they do it. I don't understand how they do it. They're master manipulators. They are master manipulators. That just came to me right before I got on camera here. I wasn't thinking about it all day or anything like that. Okay, so let's just go to Psalm. Let's go to Psalm 27. This is always a good psalm. They're all good, of course, but let's pray. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Now, this means, whom shall I fear? You fear God only, okay? If we fear man, it will bring a curse on us, so to speak, okay? If you fear man, then that's the detour you're going to take, is down a wrong path of decisions and thinking. The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? Because if you're walking in truth, you don't have to be afraid of people, okay? Because God will be on your side. God is on our side for those of us who walk in truth. And it might not look like he is at times, but in the end, he really is. Okay? He lets us go through things to not to test us so much as just, this is the way it is. Walk through it fearlessly and just walk fearlessly. Don't start thinking about how powerful somebody is over you, or I mean, you can respect people. It's good to respect people, but it's also good to be no respecter of persons. Okay, that's where we get in trouble. That's where we become man pleasers and political correctness. Okay, and I'm guilty. I'm guilty of it. Okay, I'm always working on it, getting past these things, and trying to use self-control and all these things. Psalm 27, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. It's a supernatural thing. God allowed them to stumble and fall. And I'm not thinking about anybody in particular. Just pray these prayers every day. And first of all, the devil behind it all, he's the one, first of all, he's the wicked one. He's the wicked one, and we need to expose him. Always try to expose the devil before you even try to talk about mankind. Because he's behind all of it. And people that don't know God, or people that are trying to get to know God, they might not walk in it exactly the way they should at first, or even ever. Some people are literally mentally ill. Some people are mentally ill. They cannot help it. They don't have a conscience. They can't help it. And it's the strangest thing. That's one strange thing I've run into in my entire life, is that people without a conscience, and sometimes I just think these people out there, the left, the liberals, the Democrats, are without a conscience. They don't even allow God to convict them of sin. They don't even think they have sin. And the Bible talks about all of this, okay? Okay, though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. The house of the Lord is bigger than four walls of a church. Okay, I'm not slamming church. I'm just saying, look beyond the four walls of the church. The New Jerusalem, okay, in heaven, where the house of the Lord is right here with us right now, okay? And you know, I don't downplay gathering in a church service or anything like that. I'm not talking about that. You understand what I'm saying. As I said in my other video yesterday or day before, you understand what I'm saying. Your spirit understands what I'm saying, okay? And this is the word of God. It's not that I'm saying it. I'm just talking about the word. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion. Hide us, Lord, in your pavilion. Hide us and our families, our loved ones, in your pavilion, Lord. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock. Yes, Lord, set us up upon a rock. And now shall mine head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. It's a supernatural joy. The joy of the Lord is our strength. The joy of the Lord will always be our strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is our strength. And the devil hates that. The devil cannot stand it. He can't stay around where there's joy. Okay, not silliness. Not silliness. I'm not talking about silliness. But joy. Okay, and yeah, we can have fun. We can have fun. And now shall mine head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice. Have mercy also upon me, and answer me, yes, Lord. When thou saidest, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me. We send your word out into the atmosphere, Lord. Out into the world, out into the country, out into the cities and the states and the towns, out into the neighborhoods, out into businesses. We send your word out into schools and teachers, Lord, in politicians, in Jesus Christ's holy name, law enforcement. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my mother and my father, when my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in the path, plain path, because of mine enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of mine enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty. We come against the cruelty. We come against the crime and the cruelty and the cruelty of politicians, of lawmakers that are out for blood. These prosecutors out for blood for President Trump and his supporters. And, you know, the Mike Lindell, the people that dropped him. These people that believed the lie that dropped Mike Lindell and his company because they believed the lie, because they are holier than thouest. These companies, they don't even know the truth. They just listen to a lie. They listen to CNN. They listen to MSNBC. They listen to ABC, NBC, and CBS. Yes, those people are maybe not as heavy on the lies as the others. But they listen to the lies because they went along with being man-pleasers. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord, in Jesus Christ's holy name. Amen. Yes, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Let's just do a little bit more here, okay? Let's do Galatians 5. Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Father, wherever there's bondage, untangle us from bondage, Lord, in Jesus Christ's holy name. And Father, deliver us where we need to be delivered in Jesus' name. Because sometimes things are so heavy. Sometimes things are so heavy. And you have to just walk through things with God, God's help, giving you strength, and just keeping your mouth shut, like Jesus did when they accused him. Behold, I, Paul, say unto you that if ye be circumcised, Christ shall profit you nothing. It's not us doing this on our own, okay? If we try to do this on our own, it profits us nothing. And Lord, we are asking you to take over and do the impossible for us in our lives. Make a way where there seems to be no way. You are the way. You're going to have to do this, Lord, because we are helpless without you. And it's not a weak thing at all. It's a Christ thing. It's an in Christ thing. And when he brings us out, he will get the glory. When he brings us out, anytime he brings us out, heals us, delivers us, does anything for us, give him glory. He gets the glory. For I testify again to every man that is circumcised. This is spiritual circumcision, okay? We're talking about spiritual circumcision. That he is a debtor to do the whole law. Christ is become of no effect unto you, whosoever of you who are justified by the law, you are fallen from grace. That's what fallen from grace means. Many people will say that, you've fallen from grace because you sinned. No, this is what fallen from grace means, is that Christ has become of no effect unto you, whosoever of you who are justified by the law. You have fallen from grace. This gets taken out of context all the time. Somebody sinned and they've fallen, or oh, they're in the news and they've fallen from grace. No, that's not what that means. That means they just messed up royally. They screwed up. For we through the Spirit wait for the hope of righteousness by faith. For in Jesus Christ neither circumcision availeth anything nor uncircumcision, but faith which worketh by love. Ye did run well. Who did hinder you that ye should not obey the truth? This persuasion cometh not of him that calleth you. A little leaven leaveneth the whole lump. I have confidence in you through the Lord that ye will be none otherwise minded, but he that troubleth you shall bear his judgment, whosoever he be. And you need to forgive. Always continually forgive people. And I, brethren, if I yet preach circumcision, why do I yet suffer persecution? Then is the offense of the cross ceased? I would they were even cut off which trouble you. For brethren, ye have been called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. But if ye bite and devour one another, take heed that ye be not consumed one of another. This I say, then walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary the one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. But if ye be led of the Spirit, ye are not under the law. Hallelujah. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envyings, murders, all this stuff, all this hatred for Trump. Yes. Yes, it all falls right under here. Envyings, murder from your heart. Even if you didn't murder somebody, murder from your heart, drunkenness, revelings, and such like, of the which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. But this is my favorite verses of the Bible right here. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith. Now, I'm not perfect in all these, I'll tell you that. Meekness, temperance, we work at it. Against such there is no law. This is a spiritual, lawful thing here, okay? This is law. This is spiritual law, okay? Meekness, temperance, against such there is no law. This is Galatians 5. And they that are Christ's have crucified the flesh with the affections and lusts. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not be desirous of vainglory, provoking one another, envying one another. And Lord, I just lift it all up to you. Pray it help us by your grace. We give you all the praise and glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Have a good evening, sweet dreams. Have a good day. Have a good week. Be safe. Be healthy. Be healed in Jesus' name. Healed in Jesus' name. Lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Call on the elders of the church. Anoint you with oil and pray. If you've committed any sins, that they will be forgiven. The church needs to get back to these things, okay? The church, if you're going to do church, if you are going to do church, you need to get back to these things. The people of God need help. The people of God are starving for the word. Okay? So I just thank you, Father, for this day. For your body, the body of Christ, and our country. Protect us, Lord. We come against cyber crime. We come against this cyber crime, this ransomware. We bind it. Come in agreement with me. We bind it. Just come in agreement with me. We take authority over it. In the name of Jesus Christ, we bind it on earth. It's bound from heaven. We also come against drought in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for bringing your gentle rain continually, Lord, weekly, Lord, snow even, Lord, in June. Whatever it takes to restore what the earth needs, what the people need, Lord. And we come against the games that people are playing in politics. We come against it in the name of Jesus. We lift up Dr., so-called Dr., Fauci. I pray for conviction of sin, of being a liar. I lift up the other liars in government too. The liars. Mostly Democrats. Nancy Pelosi, liar. Adam Schiff, liar. Others, liars. We bind the lies in Jesus' name. We come against the lies in media and their manipulations in Jesus Christ's holy name. We pull down the stronghold of it right now in Jesus Christ's holy name. Hold them accountable, God. Even Jen Psaki. For manipulating and lying about the previous administration. In Jesus' name, thank you, Father, protecting our country. Touch our world. Touch our military, our troops, their families. We bind the games people are playing in our military, in our education system, in our politics, in Congress, in the White House, in media. We bind the stronghold of the political witchcraft and witch hunts over even local, more local jurisdictions of New York City and this attempt to continue to bring President Trump down with manipulated lies? Hold these people accountable, Lord. We give you praise and glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Okay, God bless.